How's it going, Cersei? I'm Vanska Angeles with Pride TV.
And I'm Troy Heaton. On our show, we will share a story on our school's marching band with Gabe Valdez, an interesting insight on the impact of school spirit with Bella Simonelli.
And lastly, bra moments. Pride TV starts now. With hard work and dedication, the marching band shows off their talent. Let's see what Gabe Valdez says all about it.
I never knew how much work they put into to get the right steps and notes to play out.
Many things that make football games exciting: the crowd, the cheerleaders, the players. But the one thing that makes football games thrilling is the Cersei High School marching band. We got together with two band members to see what it takes to perform in the marching band.
Please welcome the Cersei High School Marching Lion Band.
Marching every morning isn't easy, from facing the heat to being out in the cold, but it makes them better as individuals on their marching, from staying in step to hitting the sets perfectly.
We'll go outside every once in a while, march, practice the four songs we're learning now. Sometimes we'll go inside, we'll just do memorization music.
We're working on four songs: Welcome to the Jungle, Jungle Boogie, Joy to the Jungle, and Jungle World.
I'm excited for the contest that's coming up. I'm excited for the football games we've been doing. And I'm also excited for the new freshmen that came in, teach them everything we learned last year.
I'm looking forward to World Memorial and Homecoming. It's like the energy that people give off. It's fun.
Each individual member plays their own role. They all come together at the end of the day as a band to put on a good halftime show for the audience on Friday nights.
Make sure you go out and support your Cersei High School marching band tomorrow at the Region Marching Contest. It will be from 5 to 9 at the Lions Stadium. We wish them the best of luck and hope they bring us a dub. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Gabe. It's great to see how a band can come together to make an amazing showcase for everyone to see.
Spirit Week is one of the highlights of the school year, with everyone participating in the fun that comes along.
Sounds creative. Let's get into Bella's story.
There's one week in the school year that definitely stands out more than others. This is called Spirit Week. Spirit Week is a time where we can all come together and have some friendly competition and compete to see who can come up with the best costume.
Creativity is one of the main aspects of Spirit Week, along with showing love for our Cersei Lions.
I think Spirit Week's a good time for all of us to come together as a school and a student body and, you know, just celebrate Cersei and, you know, homecoming week and all that stuff. I think it's really fun.
Spirit Week is a good opportunity to show your creativity and show people, like, it's just kind of to kind of express yourself in different ways.
Spirit Week comes participation. There are many people who participate and many who don't, but it's always good to show school spirit.
I think there's a good amount of people participating, and it's the people who have school spirit and who, you know, they're excited about it. So I think it's good. I'm happy with the amount of people that have.
I only see the people that, there's some people that are participating, but there's only, like, I feel like there's around 40% of the people are participating.
Many people wonder why we have Spirit Week, and the answer is to simply come together and mostly to have fun.
We have Spirit Week so that our student body can come together and just celebrate homecoming week and, you know, post on social media together and just be unified for a week.
The main reason I wanted to wear this is because I knew everybody was going to kind of dress up the same and it was going to look normal, and I think everybody needs a laugh sometimes, so.
Overall, with all these creative ideas, you could say Spirit Week was a hit. It was amazing to see how everyone could come together for one week. Now back to the anchors.
Wow, that's a lot of school spirit. I love seeing people dress up and showing their school spirit.
You're right. Now on to our new segment, Bra Moments. We're counting down some epic fails that really make you say, bruh.
Bruh. Bruh.
That's one of a kind.
That was really something.
Now, let's chat about lunch.
For tomorrow's lunch, we're having taco salad with cheese, lettuce and salsa, refried beans, fruit punch, cinnamon rolls with glaze, milk variety, and pear.
Sounds like another great lunch from our awesome lunch ladies. Make sure to thank them.
Before my stomach starts growling, let's continue with our last story,
which is a package on school rules. Take it away, Kennedy.
School is a big place full of a ton of students, so of course there needs to be rules, a whole handbook of them to be exact. But there are some rules that the kids at SHS aren't particularly fond of. We talked to some students to find out what they are.
School rules are implemented for a reason, but some of them people don't exactly agree with.
I think that a few rules in the dress code are unnecessary, and I think that no phones in the hallway is a bit unnecessary.
School rules are made so that we can stay focused.
A good thing about no phones in the hallway is that you can pay attention to where you're going and not bump into people whenever you're in the hallway, and dress code definitely can make you more focused in school. I think that most of the teachers have heard complaints from students about these rules, and I think that they're really listening to us. I think they were implemented to keep us more focused on our schoolwork instead of what's going on social media and texting, because while we're at school, we should really be focused on our schoolwork.
I personally don't have any bias for school rules, but I think I don't understand the whole water bottle, the clear water bottle thing, and I can get the whole covered bottle opaque. I can understand that because you don't know what's in that, but clear water bottles I think should be allowed.
Even though we might not agree with these rules, we still have to abide by them. So students, please be mindful. Now back to the news desk.
That's a lot of rules for us to follow.
Well, Cersei, that's all we have here today.
If you missed an episode, make sure you go to CerseiLionPress.com and click on the Watch Us link. If you have a topic for us to cover, hashtag PrideTV on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. And last but not least, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Cersei High Lion TV.
Stay tuned for our next episode of Pride TV. I'm Bianca Angeles.
And I'm Trey Heaton. Have a great day, Cersei High.